Here's a quick recap of the tournament that was held to crown the first ever North American heavyweight champion. Let's meet the eight participants. The Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. Sting. The Universal Heartthrob, Austin Idol. Ricky, the Dragon, Steamboat. The Masked Superstar. Wildfire, Tommy Rich. The Honky Tonk Man. And Magnum TA. To make the competition fair to everyone, managers were barred from ringside. Ted DiBiase and Sting were the first two superstars to face off. DiBiase got the jump on Sting and delivered a couple of low blows that left the Stinger writhing in pain. Sting dished out some lower body pain of his own, stretching out DiBiase's hamstrings. A key moment in the match occurred when DiBiase delivered a trio of well-placed fist drops. The third one of the set caused a severe laceration on Sting's forehead. Despite the wound, Sting rallied and stunned DiBiase with a tombstone pile driver. An impressive military press drop. And a DDT. But DiBiase continued to inflict damage to Sting's head, opening the already deep cut even more. While Sting laid on the mat, drenched in his own blood, DiBiase took to the turnbuckles to bask in his own greatness. Like a shark who smells blood in the water, DiBiase knew it was time to move in for the kill. With a reverse flying elbow drop, DiBiase drove the stake through Sting's heart. Due to the amount of blood he lost, Sting was too weak to kick out, and he became the first victim of the night. Of course, being the generous person that he is, the Million Dollar Man had a parting gift for his fallen competitor. At least Sting's not going home empty-handed. Two of the best physiques in pro wrestling squared off in the second match. Austin Idol got off to a good start against Ricky Steamboat, and he let everyone know about it. Steamboat struggled to get any offense in, as Idol relentlessly pounded him with a variety of moves. Much to the crowd's delight, Steamboat came roaring back. But Idol short-circuited his momentum with a classic eye rake. The Universal Heartthrob used his famous Las Vegas leg lock to push Steamboat to his limits. The Dragon had to literally fight his way out of the hold, and then followed up with a jarring neckbreaker. Steamboat trapped Austin Idol in a sleeper hold that had him struggling for his very survival. The ever-resourceful Idol was able to snap out of it, and then retaliated with a vicious pile driver. Certain that their hero was done, the fans erupted with excitement when the Dragon kicked out at 2.5. Riding a wave of adrenaline, Steamboat climbed the turnbuckles and executed a perfect flying body press that stole the win right out from under Idol. With that, Steamboat is through to round two. You can bet that the Million Dollar Man has a $1 bill with Steamboat's name on it. The third match of the evening pitted the Masked Superstar against Tommy Rich. The two former foes renewed their rivalry from Georgia Championship Wrestling. This exchange of wrestling holds set the tone for the entire match. It didn't take long for emotions to boil over. Neither wrestler was able to gain a clear-cut advantage over the other. When the superstar hit his trademarked corkscrew neckbreaker, things looked very bleak for Wildfire. But, it was not enough to put him away. Rich fired up the crowd, and himself. He was able to string together a series of moves and finally seize the momentum. A sleeper hold would ultimately turn out the lights of the superstar, eliminating him from the competition. The question remains, will this momentum carry over into the second round for Rich? The final match of the first round saw former Intercontinental Champion, the Honky Tonk Man, versus the former United States Champion, Magnum T.A. From the opening bell, the Honky Tonk Man largely dominated the bout. Magnum T.A. finally got the opening he was waiting for, but squandered the opportunity playing to the crowd. After all, he who hesitates is lost. Whether doing damage to Magnum T.A. on the outside or the inside of the ring, the Honky Tonk Man proved to be quite a dangerous opponent. With Magnum T.A. now significantly worn down, the Honky Tonk Man took his assault to the air, brimming with confidence. Deep into the match, Magnum T.A. finally mounted a comeback. When the Honky Tonk Man kicked out at 2 3/4, Magnum took issue with the referee's count. His frustration continued when the Honky Tonk Man countered his belly-to-belly suplex. And, his luck went from bad to worse, when a pile driver by Honky busted him wide open. Seizing the opportunity, the Honky Tonk Man pummeled Magnum's head repeatedly, turning what was a trickle into a gusher. The Honky Tonk Man then delivered the shake, rattle, and roll neckbreaker and quickly covered Magnum for the pin. But Magnum showed his fighting spirit by kicking out immediately, leaving the Honky Tonk Man exasperated. With the blood draining from his body, Magnum unloaded on Honky with a renewed sense of urgency. But, the flurry of punches left him too weak to go for the pin. Refusing to give up, Magnum hit the belly-to-belly suplex, and this time, Honky's shoulder stayed down. If only the Honky Tonk Man's manager Jimmy Hart could have been ringside, I'm sure the outcome would have been different. But as it stands, Magnum T.A. joins the final four. The first semi-final match between Ted DiBiase and Ricky Steamboat may have begun in the ring, but it did not stay there very long. Steamboat nearly took DiBiase's head off, but Ted returned the favor. A Boston Crab put the Million Dollar Man in a difficult position, but he summoned the strength to power out. Once again, the two combatants found themselves on the outside of the ring. DiBiase threw Steamboat onto the entrance ramp, but was unable to connect with a kick. Steamboat delivered a textbook dropkick to DiBiase's back and sprinted toward the ring. He successfully made it back inside by the count of eight, as DiBiase struggled to clear the cobwebs. Though he narrowly escaped being counted out, DiBiase's momentum was long gone, and he found himself at the mercy of Steamboat. Steamboat's running neck snap would be the beginning of the end for DiBiase. Just as he had done earlier in the night, Steamboat climbed the turnbuckles and waited for DiBiase to get back to his feet. This time, however, it would be a flying chop to the skull that would ultimately freeze the assets of the Million Dollar Man. With a loss, DiBiase was now free to return to his chalet in the Antilles, while Steamboat moved on to the championship round. While Tommy Rich did get out of the gate first against Magnum TA, it became obvious that Magnum had learned his lesson from his previous match. He fought hard to keep the match even, and not risk falling behind. Wildfire continued to battle Magnum, but he just was unable to match the intensity level of his opponent. Three hard right hands to Rich's face would leave the former NWA World Champion bloodied and in pain. In the end, Magnum TA would need just over 4 minutes to finish off Tommy Rich. It was quite a turnaround from his struggle to slip past the Honky Tonk Man. That means that we will see a showdown between Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Magnum TA for the North American Heavyweight title. And now, we present to you the championship match, in its entirety.
From Honolulu, Hawaii, weighing in at 235 pounds, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat! And his opponent, from Virginia Beach, Virginia, weighing in at 245 pounds, Magnum T.A. Looking for adventure in whatever comes our way. Yeah, darling, go make it happen. Take the world in a loving embrace. Fire all of the guns and bombs and explode into space. I like smoking lightning. Heavy metal thunder. Racing with the wind. It is for the North American Heavyweight Championship. Thank you.
get your motor running. Head out on the highway, looking for adventure. And whatever comes our way, yeah.
The winner and new North American Heavyweight Champion, Magnum T.A.
Congratulations to Magnum T.A. on becoming the KWA's first North American Heavyweight Champion. The Honky Tonk Man, Tommy Rich and Ricky Steamboat would all fall victim to his belly-to-belly suplex, paving his way to the title.